Look here, there and yonder, the world is full of wonder. For all the where in my house and the when what wears, there's but one place worthy Achala Bharati. There's but one place worthy Achala Bharati.
Achala Vismaya Loka, an amazing world of limitless fun. Brought to you by Achala Bharati Trust.
Children, so far we saw in the last episode that Dharmaraya places a condition for Arjuna. He says, until you free the Kaurava and bring him here, I am not going to eat or drink anything. Dharmaraya tells Arjuna, Arjuna, take your army and go and fight Chitrasena and free Kaurava and bring him here. Chitrasena is like laughing. What is this? Dharmaraya is asking Arjuna to fight and free the Kaurava. Chitrasena says, I am helping you all. Your brother, your Kaurava, has exiled you all in the forest. This exile in the forest is like a prison to you all. Now, I have captured that Kaurava and you must all feel very happy about it. You guys had to do this, but instead of you all, I have done this job for you. And I have fought for you all. Now, you all have come to fight against me. Arjuna says, no, it's not like that. I have to listen to what my brother is asking me to do. This is the right thing to do because brother has asked me. So, he says to Chitrasena, just release my brother. Otherwise, I'll have to fight and move forward. Then Chitrasena feels very confused and sad. Children, there is a poem in Kannada. If a person is mild like a sadhu, then you also must be the same towards that person. If a person speaks good, then you must speak good to that person. If someone for no reason fights with you all, then you should fight with that person. This must be your reaction always. But these people are not like that here. Now Kaurava has been tied up and Chitrasena says, okay people, you do whatever, and Chitrasena gives up, releases the Kaurava. Then Arjuna takes the released Kaurava and brings him to Dharmaraya. Kaurava will put his head down and be so sad. Dharmaraya asks, what happened? Why are you sitting with your head down this way? Dharmaraya says, if something bad happens to you, it is like something bad happened to me also. You can just imagine how big-hearted Dharmaraya is. With all the beating Kaurava gave, still Dharmaraya replies this way to him. He says, whoever gave you so much misery and tied you up, the misery we all are also feeling. We all are brothers, isn't it? If harm happens to one of us, then it's like happened to all of us too. Dharmaraya says, look, Bhishma, Drona and Krupa all told you, but still you went ahead. But Chitrasena is a Gandharva. You cannot win against Chitrasena, says Dharmaraya. So the Kaurava hands and legs will be bound and the ropes have to be cut free. In olden times, whenever the knots could not be untied, a Pativrata, that is a woman devoted to her husband, would be summoned. It is said that in those days, the knots would come loose when untied by a Pativrata. That is possible only by Draupadi. And so Dharmaraya summons Draupadi to come and cut off the ropes. Draupadi now has a chance to make fun of the Kaurava. But she may not do that in front of everyone. She may do it in her personal time among other people. So Draupadi says, look, my brother-in-law has been tied up and now I am freeing him up. How painful it must be for him for having tied up this way. That bad one, Chitrasena, did not know that he is my brother-in-law and he has tied up and tortured him. She turns to Kaurava and says, look, that evil Chitrasena, he has tied you up. She frees her brother-in-law and then she says, your body must be aching being tied up this way. In palaces, if you are hurt, they bring the palace boxers or the fighters to rub oil on the injured. But in the forest, there are no boxers or fighters because this is not a palace. Draupadi and everybody else are living in thatched roof and they have very bare minimum facilities. There is no people to massage or do such things, or do they have a bed or a resting place. They just have animal skins that they sit on and sleep. So she apologizes with the Kaurava. She kind of pokes up Kaurava with these kind of shortcomings, saying that they do not have anything here. The poet says that when Draupadi was attacking him with strong words, Duryodhana, to protect himself from the onslaught of the sharp stinging arrows of harsh words, used mauna or silence as a shield. So Draupadi is saying that what she had to do, she does not have the luxury now because she is living in such dire situation in the forest. She says, now we cannot wash you and treat you well because we have no bed or people to help. You come from a palace where you have all these luxuries. So like this, she is really talking to Kaurava but also piercing his mind as to all the things that she is missing out in the forest compared to what is available for the Kaurava in the palace. The Kaurava is really silenced by her talk. Imagine, this is the same person, the Kaurava, who was a king, a big show-off guy, the guy who laughed loudly, who made fun of others, now in shackles in front of Draupadi. Now he is dead silent when Draupadi is speaking, especially when Arjuna, Dharmaraya all speak. Even at that time, the Kaurava is silent. Now he is free. And he says, I want to return back to my palace. He does not say thanks or bow to Dharmaraya for releasing him. He just leaves the place to go to his palace. We will see what happens next.